Boating on Lake Champlain can be a wonderful experience, or it can be a disaster. The difference can depend on how much a skipper knows about navigation.
I mean, driving a car, it's not going to sink. It might break down and you can call and get help. But if you're out in the water and either A, you don't know what navigational aids are, and you go on the wrong side of one and you run your boat aground, that boat can sink.
Understanding rules, markers, and charts is a start, but on Saturday, one couple learned how important it is to keep charts up to date. Using old charts, they ran aground, lost power, and had to be towed in. Thankfully, nobody was hurt and their boat did not sink, but it doesn't always end that way, especially for boaters going fast.
There's no seatbelts on boats, so if you were to hit something, a rock or a shoal or a break wall, nothing's there to stop you besides the front windshield and whatever else is in front of you.
And, of course, drinking alcohol multiplies the risks. And another thing to bear in mind.
Just because the water temp is warm on top, there's always that if you dive down lower or if you're free diving or doing something like that, that you possibly get colder water. Your body will pretty much go in shock and want to gasp. And if you're underwater, you're going to go ahead and inhale water.
Beside the usual challenges facing boaters at the beginning of the season, anyone venturing south on Lake Champlain will have something else to watch out for, with a no-wake zone at the site of the old Champlain Bridge.
There are 4 no-wake buoys with that. That means absolutely no wake, bare minimum steerage.
Benetke says when construction starts on the new bridge, the Coast Guard may set up a new boating safety zone. With Champlain Connection, David Schneider, News Channel 5.